So before we talk about operations with sets, let's look at some examples of sets. So integers 1, 2, and 3 are a collection of three objects, namely those integers. The set formed by these three objects could be denoted like that. And again, order doesn't matter. So the size of this set then would be 3 because there are three distinct objects in it. The collection of all integers is a set. We often denote it by z, and we sometimes will denote all of the objects in that set by enumerating them with this dot 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 notation. And notice that there are an infinite number of integers, so the size of this set is infinite. The collection of all real numbers is a set, and we've already used this in this course. We've often said that, say, alpha is an element of R. And obviously, we were already using set notation at that point. So it's denoted by R. Its size is infinite, but it turns out you can't even enumerate them. So it's uncountably infinite, is what they say. But that's a topic of a different course. The set that we have concerned ourselves very frequently is the set Rn, which is the set of all vectors that have n real values as their components. And we've often talked about some vector x being an element of Rn. So, in other words, we've been using sets all along, we just haven't talked about it very explicitly.